Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create a PowerPoint presentation in ASP .NET Core using the Syncfusion .NET PowerPoint Presentation Library. The Syncfusion Presentation Library provides support for creating, editing, and manipulating PowerPoint presentations programmatically. It enables the integration of various elements such as slides, text, shapes, images, and more. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create an ASP.NET Core application in Visual Studio and install the Syncfusion Presentation NET Core package. I will show the steps to create a PowerPoint presentation by adding slides, text, bullets, and images. Let's begin with the application creation process. I opened Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project from the project dashboard. Here, I choose an ASP.NET Core web app with MVC pattern from a list of project templates. Name the project Getting Started and continue with the default target framework. Now, a project is created and is ready to use. Next, let me start creating a PowerPoint document. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion Presentation NET Core package in this application. To begin, I open the NuGet Package Manager and in the Browse tab, search for Syncfusion Presentation NET Core and install it in my application. This will install the package along with its dependencies. Now, the NuGet package is installed successfully. Once the package has been installed, I need to register a valid trial license key. Open the program.cs file and use the register license method to do this. To know where to generate this license key, refer to the link in the video description. Now, let me give an overview of the output example document. Look at this PowerPoint presentation, which includes text, bullets, and images. I am going to create a similar presentation using the Syncfusion Presentation Library. Before demonstrating the PowerPoint presentation creation process, I want to show you how it will be implemented in this application. To begin, I open the index.cshtml file and remove the existing code. Then, I set up an HTML form with the action attribute set to create presentation and the controller attribute set to home. Next, I specify that the HTTP method to be used for submitting the form data is the GET request. Then, end the HTML form. Inside the form, include an HTML division element that contains a header tag, paragraph tag, and an input element of type submit with their respective contents. When this code snippet is implemented, a button labeled Create Presentation will be generated for submitting the form when it is clicked. Now let me save the changes and run the application. Looking here, the defined content and button component are displayed in the page. As I said earlier, I am going to generate a PowerPoint presentation by clicking this Create Presentation button. Within the homecontroller.cs file, I add the Syncfusion presentation namespace. Then, I add the action method called Create Presentation with a return type of action result. Inside this method, I initialize the PowerPoint presentation instance using create method. This method returns an object, and I assign it to the variable PPTX doc of type iPresentation, which can be used to manipulate the presentation. Now, let me explain how to add slides to the PowerPoint document. Here, I plan to add 3 slides. The first slide will have the title, followed by the second slide with content, and the final slide will consist of bullet points and an image. Let me start adding the title type slide. To do this, I use the add method of the slides property in the PowerPoint presentation object, passing slide layout type title as the parameter. This operation will result in the creation of a new slide, containing a placeholder text box specifically designed for the title. The newly generated slide will be assigned to a variable named slide of type iSlide. Within the layout of this slide, the title shape can be accessed from the shapes collection, which will be assigned to the variable title shape of type iShape. Next, I remove the description shape from this slide using the removeAt method. Next, I add a paragraph to the text body of the shape using the addParagraph method. The content of this paragraph will be set as Azure Pipelines. Which will be assigned to the variable paragraph of type iParagraph. I customize the appearance of the text by configuring font properties such as the name and text formatting style. Next, I need to save the document. So, I first create a memory stream. Then, call the save method by passing the stream. After saving the document, it is important to release the memory consumed by the PowerPoint document instance. Therefore, call the close method and reset the memory stream position to start reading or writing the data from the beginning again. Finally, I download the PowerPoint document in the browser using the file method, which is a helper method in ASP.NET. It allows creating a file result object that will be sent as a response to the browser. This method is used to return the file as a PowerPoint presentation to the browser. I provide the saved memory stream object as a parameter for the presentation that needs to be downloaded. MIME type of the file that is being returned, and the name of the saved file. Now, let me run the application and click the Create Presentation button. Look at the output document, you will see that the added title text is displayed on the PowerPoint slide. Moving on to the second slide, as mentioned earlier, I plan to add the content alone. I pass the slide layout type .title and content as a parameter to the add method. This layout typically includes 2 shapes, one for title at the top of the slide, and another for the content below it, where additional information can be added. In this slide, I remove the title shape using the removeAt method. Then, I get the description shape from the slide. Next, I add a paragraph to the text body of the shape using the addParagraph method. The content of the paragraph is set using the text property. Customize its appearance by setting properties such as the list format type, font size, line space, and left indent. In the output document, you can see that the added description text is displayed properly on the slide. Now, let's move on to the third slide. To include text with bullet points and a corresponding image, I use the add method and pass the slide layout type blank as a parameter. To add bullet points, I create a text box in the slide using the addTextBox method and pass the position and size of the text box as parameters. Then, I assign it to the iShape interface variable, bullet point shape. Next, I add a paragraph to the text body of the shape using the addParagraph method, and assign it to the variable heading paragraph of type iParagraph. Then, customize its appearance by setting properties such as the line space, font size, font type, and list format type. Next, I plan to add 5 bulleted paragraphs. To do this, I create paragraphs as I did previously, and set the list format type of the bullet point paragraph as bulleted. Let me now show you how to add an image to the slide. I create a new folder named Data in the project, and add the image to be displayed in the PowerPoint presentation. I read the image file from a specified location using a file stream object, and add it to the slide at a specified position and size using the addPicture method. In the output document, you can see that the added bulleted text and image are displayed on the slide. In this video, I have shown you how to create a PowerPoint presentation in ASP .NET Core using the presentation library in Visual Studio 2022. You'll learn how to add slides, text, bullet points, and images. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our presentation library if you are eligible for our community license. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching this video.